Carla has a question.
So my question would be, can you make captions somehow?
You can make captions inside of Captivate, yes. There is, you select the audio track and there is a captioning area. I am not a huge fan of the styling for it, but we can get into that more later.
Can I save a caption file like an SRT?
No.
No.
That's one of the things I hate.
Yeah.
Does Camtasia
do that? Captivate.
Yeah, it does actually.
What's that?
Camtasia produces SRT, right?
Yes, Camtasia will produce SRT. And boy, I hope they keep that in future versions. Because Camtasia, which is a totally different tool, it will actually also do voice to text. And if it's you doing it and you've trained your computer by doing all the like the silly dog jump over the hill and the kind of voice training things, it's actually pretty dang good.
Okay.
But that's only the PC version.
How about OBS? Does that do
no.
any of this stuff?
No. OBS is a straight up screen, webcam, recorder. It can also do a cool thing where like you can play a video in the background and have yourself talking over the top and stuff.
Oh, like Mr. Science Theater.
Yeah, totally. Put your silhouettes in there and like do commentary.
Any other questions in the last minute?
What other accessibility issues do we need to worry about when we're doing things like this?
Well, you need to make sure you're not exporting to Flash. You also need to make sure that all the alt tags are on your images. You also, I mean, captions is very important. Other accessibility options. If you're not doing the PowerPoint thing, Captivate actually has a pretty fancy responsive design authoring environment where it gives you by default like computer screen size, tablet size, smartphone size, and I actually did my project in that. So then it actually looks better on the different devices, which it's pretty neat. So,
so
also there's just the accessibility, that you need to think about. Don't put purple text on your blue background. I mean, have appropriate amounts of white space, use alignment and good design principles, those kind of things that are more design-based for accessibility.
I was gonna say that the captioning issue is probably one of the more complex issues with Captivate. It's one reason why it's easier if you're doing fairly basic presentations, text, images, with PowerPoint without complex animations. You can export that to a video fairly easily. And then if there's a student with need, you can get that caption by Bernie pretty easily.
Yep.
If you point it Bernie to an interactive...
That's
oh.
me. So, yeah, if you need captioning. That's me, yeah.
Well, in fact, so maybe you could... I hate to put you on the spot, but what if somebody said, hey, I have this interactive Captivate presentation.
Replay has a video tutorial on how they do it, and it's you have to take the SRT and chop it up and throw it into Captivate's tool, and it takes forever.
Yeah, that's how storyline was too. So a lot of these tools aren't as easy as something like a video on Kaltura.
A straight up video, the captioning can be done in bulk. It's straightforward. It's easy. So if you do put any videos inside of Captivate, you can embed Kaltura and YouTube videos in there. You can make sure those videos have captions.
And that kind of brings up the question of how much do you think that you actually need to do? How deep into the Captivate hole do you need to go? Or is there something that you could do that can accomplish the same educational goals in a much simpler, much more accessible format?
Yep. I mean, that was the conversation we had over there at that table, was, you know, this is what I'm doing, do I need to do this? And it all depends on what you're going for, what your goals are, the amount of interactivity you think they need to have, the amount of passivity that you think is okay. These videos tend to be more passive. These kinds of things tend to be more interactive. If it's an all online program and all they're doing is watching 100 hours of videos, you know, so it's a longer conversation.
All right. We are over time. If you have more questions, please come on Monday. I think we're going to invite